but there was a whisper that he did not go correctly. The bamboo cane stood by, looking stiff and proud. He was vain of his brass ferrule and silver top. And on the sofa lay two worked cushions. Pretty, but stupid. When the play at the little theatre began, the rest sat and looked on. They were requested to applaud and stamp, or crack, when they felt gratified with what they saw. But the riding whip said he never cracked for old people, only for the young who were not yet married. "I crack for everybody," said the cracker. "Yes, and a fine noise you make," thought the audience as the play went on. It was not worth much, but it was very well played, and all the characters turned their painted sides to the audience, for they were only made to be seen on one side. The acting was wonderful, excepting that sometimes they came out beyond the lamps, because the wires were a little too long. The doll whose neck had been darned was so excited that the place in her neck burst, and the money pig declared he must do something for one of the players, as they had all pleased him so much. So he made up his mind to remember one of them in his will, as the one to be buried with him in the family vault, whenever that event should happen. They all enjoyed the comedy so much that they gave up all thoughts of the tea party and only carried out the idea of intellectual amusement, which they called playing at men and women. And there was nothing wrong about it, for it was only play. All the while, each one thought most of himself, or of what the money pig could be thinking. His thoughts were on, as he supposed, a very distant time, of making his will, and of his burial, and of when it might all come to pass. Certainly sooner than he expected. For all at once down he came from the top of the press, fell on the ground, and was broken to pieces.